too. Let's talk to Jason Pearlman. Jason is from the Henry Jackson Society. They're a foreign policy think tank. Jason, very good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me on.
Pleasure, Jason. This isn't the first time unsavoury people have come and indeed been welcomed to the country. What's the problem with this visit?
Well, I think, firstly, you know, when we're talking about the values of democracy, and the first question is should people be demonstrating? The first thing we should be saying is, yes, thankfully, we are in a country where people can demonstrate, and we can have this discussion on the radio. That isn't, you know, a given around the world. I think there will always be people who have their own concerns, and there will always be people who take different sides. But right now, I think Saudi Arabia is a country going through dramatic changes. Changes which have tremendously positive overtures for the whole of the Middle East and for Europe and for the UK especially. And, you know, I think we have to take it case-by-case basis, and then we have to see some very positive trends going on here.
Britain, historically, has always played a very pivotal role in the way Saudi, indeed, was developed. You go back as far as Winston Churchill and King Abdullah sitting in the tents in the desert. And clearly then we understood the value of what was happening to the Saudis and the benefits to the country, quite frankly, to us.
Well, the benefits may, you know, ebb and flow or come and go over the years. Right now, the number one concern for the British government and the first duty for the British government is the security of the British people, of the British citizens. And because the way Saudi Arabia has stepped up in the face of extremism and tackling issues like Iran, which is a cause of deep instability in the Middle East, I think that we will find, of course, room to talk about our concerns on human rights, and of course room to talk about concerns of the values of democracy, which the British people have historically always, you know, supported and championed. But as part of that discussion, we've also got a lot to talk about around the region to understand how Saudi Arabia is facing extremism and how that is something the British government need to be a partner in a very real way.
The situation in Yemen is atrocious, Henry. It's on a human level. It is just terrible. But I think we sometimes forget the Iranians and their involvement in Yemen, and that's perhaps why the Saudis are a bit. There is a particular geopolitical conflict going on there that we're not fully aware of the full implications. It isn't that the Saudis have just got into Yemen. There is a reason why.
Yeah, there is and people point to Yemen, but really you can't talk about this without talking about Syria. You can't talk about this without talking about Lebanon. You can't talk about this basically without seeing Iran's hand in some very, very troubling trends around the Middle East. And actually, take a step back even further. During the Obama administration, America stepped back, disengaged slightly from the Middle East. And we saw other elements move in. And we saw the rise of radical elements that caused serious concern, have had knock-on effects to security here in the UK. And America's historical allies in the region, Saudi Arabia being a key one, really looked and said, well, you know, what do we do? Where is our international support network? Now, with the Trump administration, that process had been reversed. President Trump visited Saudi Arabia. He held a pan-Arabian and Muslim council, American council meeting there with the heads of many nations from across the region. And it was very clearly said, stepping up across the region, Saudi Arabia leading the trend to face extremism. And that is Yemen. Yes, certainly, Iran are in Yemen, but it's also their efforts to forge a territorial corridor from Tehran through to the Mediterranean Sea, issues that will have a very real effect on British security.
A lot of people want to have their say today, but I need to ask you this. Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn in the Commons suggesting the UK should end its arms sales to the country. We're not in the sixth form now. We're living in the real world. We know what the arms sales mean. Can we afford to turn our noses up to the very hefty Saudi checkbook when it comes to arms sales?
I'll point to some of the fantastic research that the Henry Jackson Society has done on the relationship and where we put the emphasis on the relationship. I think that rather focus actually on the arms issue, I would look much more to see where Saudi Arabia are investing their money. The Vision 2030 has so much potential for innovation and for real investment in startups, in companies that make a real change. And I think we have so much to gain as humanity, to be honest. Really, we have so much to gain to see innovation replace education for hatred and things like that, that we can benefit tremendously by engaging on those issues. Of course we have to raise concerns about human rights, of course we have to, but at the same time there's so much to be gained that it would be silly to throw the baby out with the bathwater.
Jason, pleasure to talk to you. Thank you for your time this afternoon. Jason Pearlman from the Henry Jackson.